Filmed at Oscars in Palm Springs, it's the Mark and Tony Show, starring Mark Lantaro and Tony Pomponio. Today's guests, award-winning comedian Richard Weiss and local singing favorite Larry Capilotto. Here's Mark and Tony.
Now the tournament comes open.
We made it. How about that?
As Laura said, thank you everybody for coming to the Mark and Tony Show. We appreciate it.
Look at this lineup over here. What a crowd.
That's perfect.
It's my favorite line. You know that. By the way, hold on one second.
Okay. We're not serving. Listen, I wanted to get serious for a moment. I wanted to let everybody know, of course, next week is our anniversary show. It's our one-year anniversary show for the Mark and Tony Show.
Yes, Mr. Serious over here.
Yes. So that all being said, with that, we have a lot of entertainers that are going to be on the show. We have a lot of testimonials that will be for the show.
Absolutely.
And Tony and I could not do any of this, along with Sonny Velosi, of course, our producer who's not here this evening, that we hope he gets back here very soon. All that still being said, we appreciate the fact that the audience here live, along with our television audience, we have an opportunity to do this for you. Because back in the day when Sonny, Tony, and myself kind of sat around and decide, well, what are we going to do now after the Mark's Place is on hiatus?
Yes.
We love to do a talk show, and we thought, well, okay, let's kind of put some things together to see how it works out. So far leading into this year anniversary, we're very thankful to all of you for the opportunity, along, of course, with the crew and everybody that's involved with the show.
We have a great audience tonight, by the way.
Yes, we have
amazing,
a great audience.
Once again,
Once again, a voice from above.
It sounds like it's God.
It's so what it is.
And there you have it. It's a woman god. So anyway, I just want to say thank you on behalf of Tony, myself, and of course Sonny and all the crew.
Yep.
So let me throw it over to you a moment, Tony,
well,
if there's
you
anything
much.
You want to add.
Well, yeah, I'd like to add something because I ran out of things to do with my leg while you're talking. it never happens. You know what?
Rodney Dangerfield, the new Rodney
Dangerfield.
Thank
God he has more battery life on his microphone than I do. Hey, look it. We've had a wonderful year. It's been fantastic.
Yes.
We've had some of the best local singers, as well as comedians, entertainers, magicians.
We have a comedian on this evening. Buddy.
Yes, absolutely. We've had so much fun. And I'll tell you what, I am so grateful that we've had this opportunity.
Mm-hmm.
It was an idea not long ago, 1 year ago was an idea. And here we are today. You know, 1 year later, as we move forward and continue to move on in new markets as well, right?
Exactly, yes. As Tony's mentioned, we'll be moving into other markets beside here locally. As a matter of fact, this evening we have a young gentleman here by the name of Richard Weiss who will be coming on to do his comedy routine. So stay tuned, everybody, because after the break, we'll bring Richard on and he can give us all of his wisdoms. Yes, Tony.
Yeah, guess what? Oh, one more thing.
Yes.
Hey, check out our new website, by the way. TheMarkAndTonyShow.com.
Perfect.
Sign up. You can follow us on TheMarkAndTonyShow.com. How about that? How about a hand?
So everybody, we'll be right back.
Kimball's Unique Boutique, located in beautiful downtown Palm Springs, is for women who are not afraid to attract attention. Our clothing is feminine, flirty, fun, and fabulous. Get the latest look. Large selection of jewelry, hats, and much more. Personalized service inspires our customers to keep coming back. Kimball's Boutique, across from the Hyde in beautiful Palm Springs. We look forward to having you shop with us, and don't forget to mention the Mark and Tony Show for your 20% discount on your purchase.
Hi, I'm Mark Lantaro.
And I'm Tony Pomponio. Tune in every Thursday at 1 o'clock on Spectrum Fox 11 or Channel 33 on The Dish and DirecTV Network.
Music, comedy, interesting interviews every week on The Mark and Tony Show. Be there!
As I said, leading into the break, we have a gentleman here by the name of Richard Weiss. He's the winner of the Coachella Valley Festival, and he's the author of the book Wisecracks. So everybody, a round of applause for Richard Weiss.
Hey!
How you doing? I give it up for these guys, Mark and Tony, everybody. What sharp dressers. You know, I watched the show and I saw that they were such good dressers and I gained some weight. I had nothing to wear, but I only wear designer clothes. So I went to my favorite brand designer, Clearance, I believe. This penguin, a flamingo. Reminds me of the last time the police pulled me over. I was on one leg and pink as well. So I'm just glad the pandemic is over. We're out again. I was hiding in my house. I'm glad to be out on stage. I'm vaccinated. I feel good. But my girlfriend, still a little paranoid when it comes to the whole thing. When we make love, I still got to wear the mask. And the mask is of Denzel Washington. So am I in this, guys, or what? So I do a lot of shows. I just yesterday did a show for the Burbank Women's Fertility Association. Yeah, they gave me a standing ovulation. Oh, they were really egging me on. That's what I'm saying, people. Okay, I'll take a moan, you know. A moan is good in the bedroom. I'll take it. The funny thing is, when I started comedy, I would get laughs on stage and moans in the bedroom. Now I get moans on stage and laughs in the bedroom. Okay, you guys are great. Hey, what a crowd. What a crowd. I did a show in Vegas a while back, and my name's Richard Weiss. Attractive woman, visibly drunk, comes up after the show, goes, "Hey, I know you. You're Vanilla Ice." I said, "That guy? Really?" She goes, "You're not Vanilla Ice, because I had a fantasy of making passionate love to Vanilla Ice for hours and hours." I'm like, "Stop. Collaborate and listen. Ice is back with a brand new edition. If there's a problem, you are solving. Check out the groove on my DJ recorder. Bum, 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 bum." At least the dance move is good, right? So yeah, I do a lot of shows. Quick about me, I had diabetes. I was 300 pounds a few two years ago. Had to lose weight. My friend, he's a vegan. He's like, "Richard, you eat veggie food, you'll lose the weight." I said, "But Steve, I don't like the taste of veggie food." He goes, "You know what? Get a veggie burger. You put something on it, it will taste good." I said, "All right, put a hamburger on it." So now my doctor's got me on a plant-based diet, weed and cocaine. Just kidding, I don't do weed, okay? A little bit about myself. I celebrated another year of sobriety, March 15th of this year. Thank you very much. A little bit worried that I'd make it. My sponsor's Johnny Depp. Too soon, too soon. I used to say Charlie Sheen, but I think Johnny Depp would have been. Yeah, yeah. I was traumatized at 9. I want to share this. I don't know why I drink, but they say sometimes your childhood. I had a cat named Little Boy. At the age of 9, my mother said, "We're going to neuter Little Boy. He's too frisky." And I knew what neutering meant. I said, "Mom, don't do it. It's cruel. Just Little Boy is a dumb animal. He will never know." Well, Little Boy went to the vet. He came back. He followed my mother everywhere after that. And he meow at her. Meow, 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 meow. I recorded and played it back real slow, and it said, "I want my manhood back, witch. Give me back my manhood. Walk like a man, talk like a man, sing like a king." Yeah. I love singing. Thank you for the blanket, bro. So I'm going to do, I know Tony does some Rodney, and honor of him, I'm going to do some Rodney. I'm going to try, okay? I'm okay now, but last week I was in tough shape, you know. My kid, I was traumatized as a kid. My parents, I lost them on the beach. I said to the cop, "Can I find them?" He goes, "I don't know, kid. There's so many places they could hide." My doctor, too. You know my doctor, Dr. Vinny Mumbats, my doctor. I told him I have suicidal tendencies. Now he makes me pay in advance. I said, "Doctor, you know, I wake up every morning, I look in the mirror, and I feel like throwing up." He says, "I don't know what's wrong with you, but your eyesight is perfect." And my wife, too. I called my wife the other day. I said, "Honey, I'm thinking about the last time we made love, and I'm getting a little excited." She said, "Who is this?" My wife. I remember even when I dated her, we didn't get along. She says, "Come on over. There's nobody home." I went over. There was nobody home. No, my wife, she cut me down to sex once a month. I'm lucky. 3 guys I know, she cut out completely. My uncle, his dying wish was to have me on his lap. He died in the electric chair. That's Rodney. I'm going to close with a song. I'm a recovering cocaine addict. I haven't done it in many years, but when I did it, I watched movies and the lyrics would be a little different to me, and I'm going to share how it was many years ago in New York City, watching The Wizard of Oz. I'd be wide awake for hours, sniffing my white powder, going quite insane. And my thoughts would be a spacing as my heartbeat starts a racing because I did too much cocaine. I'd unravel every dollar at my dealer. I would holler for an eight ball once again. Bup, 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 bup. And with all my stinking thinking, I'm so high, I think I'm Lincoln. Course I did too much cocaine.
Everybody,
thank you. Thank you. God bless. What a crowd. What a crowd.
We have an interesting gentleman sitting to my right here, Mr. Richard Wise, a great comedian and a gentleman that just adds a lot of style to the show. How in the heck did you get into comedy, and why did you go into comedy?
I went originally to come on the Mark and Tony show. Years ago.
Wait a minute. We'll pay after the show. Go ahead.
Basically, my whole life, I made jokes from Little League Baseball. I had people laughing. I worked in construction in New York City. We all had good laughs. Yeah. I came out here, my mom passed away 15 years ago, and my drinking escalated. They sent me out here on an intervention to stop drinking from New York to California. I got my first year of sobriety out here, and I wanted to get a hobby. They say get a hobby. And I had tried comedy once in New York, but I had a job. So I did well, but I never pursued it. So I joined a comedy writers class up in Santa Monica. And the first show, the 6-week class, they headlined me and we did it at the Hollywood Improv and it was great. And I'm like, okay, this is great. Now what do I do? And it just kind of rolled on from there. People would contact me. I got some shows, they paid me money for telling jokes, which was amazing to me. And then I met a lot of good people. And
good for you.
Like Steve Middleman, who was on your show.
Yes.
He's a great guy.
He's the best. Yep.
Who I had watched in New York when I never did comedy. And this guy would have us rolling and met him out here. And
the man with no chin.
The man with no chin. Well, now he has a chin. But no, that it was just like that. And I did recovery shows, recovery comedy, because I'm in recovery. So that's a niche. But I do all types of shows, nudist resorts, whatever. In fact, they booked me to do a nudist resort. I had no clothes to wear, so I...
Hey, bada bing, bada boom.
Let me know when you're there, because I won't be there. Anyway, look at Richard, I got to ask you this. Yeah. So today, actually, on my Facebook, I posted something with Don Rickles and Frank Sinatra on the Johnny Carson show. I freaking love these guys. These are guys that are old comedians that did a fantastic job. And they're our icons in your industry, as well as ours. Yeah. So who was your favorite comedian? What is it all about with you?
Growing up, there was like three. Originally, it was like Steve Martin, the corny arrow through the head. And I don't know if that would transcend today. He's a great actor and all, but Dangerfield was probably my favorite.
The best.
One-liners.
And by the way, your voice, you can imitate his voice.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, I've been told that. Yeah. And he influenced me. And then it was Richard Pryor, who was a little bit different, but he was very honest about his drug addiction and all. And when I started comedy, I said, do I get honest about my drug addiction and alcoholism? Since I'm sober, there's nothing to be embarrassed about. And I used that, went back to Philly where my dad was. He saw me perform there. He's one of my biggest fans. And it was great.
Thank you. Please. Yeah. Yes.
You know, there's nothing like something that you can be serious about and then joke about it later. You know what? You are awesome.
Thank you. Believe me,
we envy you for what you've done with your life.
Yeah, I mean, that is a big undertaking.
All the best.
And
how about that?
Yeah,
folks?
Everybody,
come on,
please.
Just give me a hand.
It's a big undertaking that you can look at it under a different lens and take stock in everything that's there. With what Tony was saying, and I just wanted to kind of segue into this, being in a lot of different comedy clubs and things that you've been part of, there has to be the venues that you extremely like, and then there's venues that, is this kind of a strange situation that I'm in. Yeah. Did you run across any of this along your travels right now?
Oh, yeah. When I started, you know, you got to get any room you can. I had some bars with meth heads in there and drunks, and you got to pay your dues, kind of, you know, and I did that. Started in Riverside, California, and worked out to Hollywood, but as you get better bookings. I do Elks Lodges, we do fundraisers, recovery shows. We'll do any show, and this is a great venue as well. I want to thank you
well,
for that.
Well, listen, we thank you for coming on the show. Yeah. With that, though, are you primarily staying in the Southern California area, or are you going out of state, be it the comedy clubs of Chicago or New York mm-hmm. or Philly?
Yeah.
I mean, mm-hmm. are you involved in any of those?
Yeah, so what do you got coming up?
Yeah.
Next, we go to Texas. Donna Main, I work with her. We have the male-female comedy thing. We do Elks Lodges, and she's a great comic. We do Clean, which is, you know, not everybody does, so we get booked. I will be, I believe, August 19th down the street at the Agua Caliente.
How about that?
Agua Casino. Caliente,
down the street. Right, yeah. Everybody.
And you're all invited to come. Just mention my name at the door and you're in, okay? It's a free show, by the way. But you're in. I'll go anywhere. I've been to New York. I stay basically around California, Arizona, because of gas prices, and it's, but
that's a joke in itself now,
oh,
right, nowadays.
It sure is, yeah, yeah. But I'll go anywhere, you know. Laughter is universal, and
It works everywhere.
Yeah, we are so happy having our show tonight.
Yes,
well, thank you.
As Tony and I said, we want to thank you very much for taking the time, because he's not a local comedian. He drove in from out of the area. Gas prices and all, as you were saying. So we want to just thank you so much
for participating
in the show tonight, and we thank you.
So, Tony, Richard, you ready?
Yeah.
We'll be right back.
Hi, I'm Mark Lantero.
And I'm Tony Pomponio.
We're here to tell you, if you missed the show on Thursdays, no worries.
You can catch a show and all of our previous shows on YouTube 24/7.
Just go to the YouTube search bar and type in The Mark and Tony Show.
The Mark and Tony Show! Be there!
GRE's Visions, visuals from concept to completion, specializing in distinctive logos, identities, and branding. From business cards to banners to billboards, GRE's Visions is your best graphic solution.
Kimball's Unique Boutique, located in beautiful downtown Palm Springs, is for women who are not afraid to attract attention. Our clothing is feminine, flirty, fun, and fabulous. Get the latest look. Large selection of jewelry, hats, and much more. Personalized service inspires our customers to keep coming back. Kimball's Boutique, across from the Hyde in beautiful Palm Springs. We look forward to having you shop with us, and don't forget to mention the Mark and Tony Show for your 20% discount on your purchase.
Ladies and gentlemen, Larry Cappelletto. We love Larry.
It's impossible tell the sun to leave the sky. It's just impossible. It's impossible tell a baby not to cry. It's just impossible. Can I hold you closer to me and not feel going through me? And the second that I never think of you, it's just impossible. Can the ocean keep from rushing to the shore? It's just impossible. If I had you, could I ever ask for more? It's just impossible. And tomorrow, should you ask me for the world, somehow I'd get it. I would sell my very soul and not regret it. For to live without your love is just impossible. Can the ocean keep from rushing to the shore? It's just impossible. if I had you? Could I ever ask for more? It's just impossible. And tomorrow, should you ask me for the world, somehow I'd get it. I would sell my very soul and not regret it. For to live without your love, it's just impossible. 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 Thank you. Thank you very much.
But how'd you get started in this business?
Well, I started actually in high school. I was in a quartet called the Dreamers.
Oh, wow.
And we used to sing at high school dances. And then when I sang in the Army when I went into the service. And when I got out of the service, I started doing nightclub shows in Seattle, which I did for a number of years. And ended up moving down here. And I couldn't get hooked up with anything for, there were so many singers down here.
Yeah.
And so I started teaching country dancing. And I became the main country dance instructor in the desert for a lot of years. Then I got hooked up with the Ted Herman Orchestra, and that's how we got started. I did 5 years. Actually, I was with Ted for 17 years, but I did 5 years at the Indian Wells Hotel, and then they asked me to do my own show. So I took over Monday nights, and I just completed my sixth year at the hotel.
How about
everybody,
that,
please, please, give it up here for Larry on that.
Yeah.
So Larry, that kind of leads me into the question. So the Ted Herman Orchestra for 17 years, out here in Indian Wells for a period of time at the resort. Everybody, that's the Indian Wells Resort here in Indian Wells. And so where did you and Ted meet that you have this history leading up to where today is?
Well, before I was a singer with the Herman Orchestra, I was a sales manager for a golf cart company, one of the biggest ones in the country.
How about that?
And Ted used to come in and see one of the guys all the time, which was a friend of his. And he kept telling this, Ted, this guy can sing. Ted says, sure, right, you know. And one finally, after about two or three times, Ted, okay, sing something for me. So I sang something for me and or for him, and he said, oh, you're my new male vocalist.
Whoa,
and
wow.
I spent 17 years being his male vocalist.
How about that,
ladies and gentlemen, that's very impressive. So being with Ted Herman and then making your way out to the Indian Wells Resort and singing in that venue, how is that unique for you? What gets you started? Because that is a unique area to begin
when
with.
When they asked me to take over Monday nights,
okay.
My wife and I got together and decided, you know, we need a kicker.
Okay.
And something, you know, three hours of me would bore me. You know.
Don't believe a word he's saying. He's got a great voice, everybody. He's being humble here.
We decided that it would be important and it would change the look of the show if we had guest artists in it every week. So we have four ladies who have rotated each week.
And each one of them has their own style.
Each one has their own style. I have Sharon Sills. I have Christy King. I have Leslie Tenero. And I have Rebecca Clark. And they're all amazing singers in their own right. So, I mean, it's just, they're just amazing. So that changed the whole show and we started getting some pretty good crowds. So, and that's what made the hotel happy.
Wow.
How about
that,
huh?
Yeah.
The IW. Yeah. How about that, folks? You know, I gotta say one thing. I have had a wonderful opportunity to perform with Larry on occasion with a group called the Sons of Italy, right?
Right.
And that'll lead me into our next question in regards to, what about side gigs, Larry? What else do you do?
Well, my favorite side gig, well, there's two of them, actually. One is doing the Sons of Italy with, you know, Tony DiGiolando, Frank DeSalvo, myself, and Michael D'Angelo.
Yeah.
We call ourselves the Ozone because all our names end up being this end on an O, so it's just a lot of fun. And I perform there once a month, every third Wednesday.
Yeah, the Sons of Italy is every Wednesday, and it's an Italian club that Larry has the opportunity to sing.
Every third Wednesday
for Larry.
I joined the Sons of Italy group a few years back. So Larry, Frank DeSalvo, Tony DiGiuliano, they would tell me, okay, Tony, we're going on a break. They go and eat, and I'm over there playing the accordion. While they're having taking a break, go, hey, guys, I'm over here. No, just keep playing. We're taking a little break here. Thank you very much for adding me to the friggin' show, Larry. No, we've had so much fun. Ladies and gentlemen, Larry Cappelletto.
Hi, I'm Mark Lantera.
And I'm Tony Pomponio. Tune in every Thursday at 1 o'clock on Spectrum Fox 11 or Channel 33 on the Dish and DirecTV Network.
Music, comedy, interesting interviews every week on the Mark and Tony Show. Be there!
Kimball's Unique Boutique, located in beautiful downtown Palm Springs, is for women who are not afraid to attract attention. Our clothing is feminine, flirty, fun, and fabulous. Get the latest look. Large selection of jewelry, hats, and much more. Personalized service inspires our customers to keep coming back. Kimball's Boutique, across from the Hyde in beautiful Palm Springs. We look forward to having you shop with us, and don't forget to mention the Mark and Tony Show for your 20% discount on your purchase.
Well, everybody, thank you for coming back to the Mark and Tony Show. We had a fantastic evening with two fantastic guests.
Oh, Richard Watts.
Amazing. So,
Larry Cappelletto.
Yeah.
Well, what Tony's trying to say in English is they were two fantastic guests, and we had a great time.
Laura, what do you think?
Oh, I think this was a stunner.
Absolutely.
The whole show.
Absolutely. So, Laura, if you would let the audience know, because you're always hidden back in the abyss back there.
You keep me in the dark.
Well, we don't want to. It's just that's the way the lighting seems to turn out back there. So,
I was just hired to be in a TV series, and I'm going to film in the fall.
Whoa. Wow, how about that?
Very good. Can you give the audience and the TV audience any info on that?
Well, it's following a movie called Mayberry Man, and now they're going to write the series.
All right.
Mayberry Man is on Netflix if you...
Oh, really? So it's already going on right now?
Yes. And now they're going to do a series in the fall, and I get to be a high-powered... businesswoman in LA.
Ladies and gentlemen, how about the new voice of the Mark and Tony Show, Hank Russ, on the... How about it? Listen to Hank every Thursday on the Mark and Tony Show on Fox.
Right, Hank does the intro for every show that we have on the Fox Network, so everybody please stay tuned for that.
I'm so glad you said that. Never has to, forget it.
I can't have the last word.
Well, always. You always have that last word. You cut me out all the time. You know, anyway.
We'll see you next week.
But you know what it is, Laura? Marcus has got the white hair going on. I'm the beast.
There is value in that.
I am the beast. Okay?
Trust me.